Ladies and gentlemen, the Zoblep Morning Show is back in the building with another heater, another hot topic. Oh, I'm excited today. There's so much going on. So many people in the building buzzing around like a beehive. It's crazy right now. You know what I'm going to do, though. I got to tell you to go get some books, and I got to tell you to go support some businesses. It's very important that we do this. Let's share the wealth. Let's spread the wealth among all of our people, everybody that's listening. You know, somebody hit me up and said, yo, man, I don't know how to get in contact with you in order to, promote my business. Well, if you want to promote your business, and my whole thing is to use this platform to build up our community, all races, all creeds, all colors, but especially the brothers and sisters who never recycle their money. Mm-hmm. So it's important that I say, hey, man, go support, you know, somebody in your community, some business in your community. How I do that is I bring on special people to talk about their business. So do me this. Email me at 2319, Z as in zebra, O as in Oscar, 1@gmail.com. 2319ZO1@gmail.com. Send me your business request. I'll read it, check it out. And if it's the flyness, I'll support it, right?
All right.
So really quickly, books, please. For everybody who supported me on this, I appreciate you. This is my book, The Rebirth of Siege. You can find it on my website, IamZoeWilliams.com. That's I am Zoe Williams, Z-O, not Zoe. That's something else. IamZoeWilliams.com. Please continue to support. Thank you all for all the people who have supported in the past. I appreciate you. Thank you very, very, very much. And of course, my good friend, Dr. Mark Goulston, continue to support his array of books. I mean, this is just listen. That's one book. He also has a book on persuasion. He has a book on getting out of your own way. I mean, he has a book on the 6 tips about relationships. He has a lot of good stuff. Please support Dr. Mark Goulston and all of his endeavors as well. And I have a particular book that I think you guys that will fit today's topic. A very good book. It's called Spank Your Child, Please. A book about children by former child Patrick Thompson. Thomas Thompson, yes. And he's talking about, you know, we have to look at this thing. I'll get into this later when I talk about today's topic. But let me move on quickly because we got people in the building. Really quickly, our show is being catered today by what I'm told is the ambrosia of Mexican cuisine.
Nice.
Right? Help me pronounce it.
Provecho.
Provecho Grill. She came, I mean, she drove far. She drove from West Hell to get here.
Otherwise known as Sun City, Menifee, California.
Otherwise known as Sun City. Please tell us about your grill. My friend swears by it. Provecho Grill. Talk to
Provecho.
Us, Rosie.
Well, Provecho means bon appetit. And we say it all the time. It has a good meaning to it. Anywhere in Latin America, it's going to be a good thing. And I wanted to bring a good vibe to Sun City.
Wow.
Sun City used to be where everybody went to retire, and now it's Menifee. So we have a lot of young people moving in. Mm-hmm. Average income now is 55. So things are changing.
Wow.
Along with that, I had the opportunity to buy a restaurant there, and we decided, all right, let's do Provecho Grill. Let's get some regional Mexican food, make it fresh.
Right.
Let's give everyone fresh, good quality Mexican food without breaking the bank.
Wow.
Let's make sure that they have certified Angus beef, great, you know, fresh seafood.
Mm-hmm.
I give them customer lots of love and attention without breaking the bank. And
wow.
That's exactly what we do. It's family run, and there's a lot of love there.
And I hear that you are a stickler for your dishes. If it ain't right, you not happy about it. I hear it's incredible. My homeboy swears by it. I said, well, geez, we gonna have to try it. And she came all the way out here. We so appreciate you. Where can they
Thank
find you?
You?
Do you guys have a website? Or
yes, we do.
What is the website? Can we put it up on the screen?
Yep. It's www.provechogrill.com.
Provecho.
Provecho. Provecho.
You don't know how to spell? P-R-O-V-E. C-H-O, right?
Grill.
grill.com.
G-R-I-L-L.
My engineer, Baby Teen Wolf, is looking like, what? Typo. We call him Baby Teen Wolf because he's really young with a full Kenny Loggins beard.
Nice.
So, Dan Haggerty style. Baby
it,
Teen
Kenny.
Wolf.
All right.
There's the grill. There's, look at, jeez Louise.
So, you guys will be having the chile güeritos right in the middle, right there next to our Provecho Burger. The pambazos from Mexico City. We tend to focus on other regions. It's not all tacos and burritos.
Wow.
We want to get away from that Baja feel because since we're in California, you kind of start getting used to, you know, San Felipe, TJ, Ensenada. Well, they have Guanajuato, which is the Latin Paris of Mexico. There's Mexico City, and it's just wonderful. That's like literally the equivalent of New York in Mexico. I mean, it's go, grab and go. So you have sopes, huaraches, you know, all that good stuff. We focus on a vegetarian menu. We focus, you know, we have a nice following of vegans. I mean, that's
it. It's going to be crazy. We so appreciate you coming, Rosie. Thank you.
We don't have a walk-in, so we cook literally day and night. Day and night.
Wow.
Make it fresh. So we don't
I'm so
food.
Blown away right now. Look, they're going to be eating later on today. They're excited, too.
Y'all smell that?
Right. Then we got another brother in the building. His name is Reggie. Reggie, what's your business? What do you do? And where can they find you right now?
Well, what's going on, folks? My name is Reggie Simon of SimonVisionMedia.com.
And I've known this dude for many, many years, by the way. He was one of the first, way back in the MySpace days, he was one of the first supporters of the Voice of Reason on Foxhole Radio. This dude supported us, man. Talk to us.
Okay. Yeah, for sure. SimonVisionMedia.com. Videographer, editor, we film weddings, special events, private events.
Oh, there's your website. There you go.
Oh, yeah. I appreciate it. Private events, music videos, sports functions.
He edited one of the first video edits of my show. He, like, created this visual effect. It was crazy. I was like, out of the blue, he reached out and said, man, I created a video for your promo. Out of the blue, and it was awesome, and we played it too, right?
I appreciate it, for sure.
Man, I just love the fact that I can reach out and help people do what they do. Tell us one more time where they can see you, where they can find you, and connect to your business.
That's right, folks. That's SimonVisionMedia.com, and all the information is there for you, including email, phone numbers, all that good stuff.
And you do weddings too, right?
We do weddings, absolutely.
Bar mitzvahs.
Bar mitzvahs. Haven't done a bar mitzvah yet.
But you would.
But I will, and I would. Absolutely. And as far as pricing is concerned, you know, we don't have a pricing structure because there's a lot of people that just like to get married, just their mom, their dad, the pastor, you know.
So you're flexible to whatever budget.
Absolutely. We don't stick anybody in any particular, you know, bracket.
Right.
If you got the budget, we'll work it out.
Right. So what if, listen, I only got $90, homie.
Understood.
You just take care of the whole wedding, get down?
Yeah. Can you give me a call back? You know,
I'm gonna need we need 37 looks though. I want to change
looks,
clothes
right.
on it, but I only got $90
with a gang of effects.
Right.
Oh man, I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to pass on that.
I got the hookup, right?
Yeah.
No, man, but we appreciate you coming in studio
Thanks
to support your
me,
business.
Man.
One more time, what's the name of the business?
SimonVisionMedia.com. I know it's a little wordy, but couldn't do productions. Reminds me of Funky Finger Productions.
Hell yeah.
So, SimonVisionMedia.com. Check it out, folks.
I appreciate you, brother, for coming in. And Rosie.
Thank you.
Provecho Grill in Sun City. If you don't go there, you're not worth anything. Your life is a failure. No, you know how I like to do. Now, I have to move on to my next piece that I'm going to promote. But let me say, I've been promoting this for a few weeks now. And I'm really disappointed. So disappointed that I'm about to make a video, a whole entire show centered around group economics, right? I talk about how we will kill ourselves to support other cultures that don't support your culture.
Oh, dang.
You understand? Mm-hmm. Like, the brother who has the T-shirts out of New York, right? I tell people, oh, his shirts are $100. Well, Gucci sells shirts for $700, right? Louis Vuitton sells shirts, T-shirts for $1,000, right? Or Versace sells a $500 or $600 T-shirt, and we complain about stuff. Let me just say, you know, a pair of Jordans are going to wear out. But the Black Mastery Program will last you for the same amount of money the rest of your life. It'll change your life.
True.
So I'm tired of promoting things that people are always making excuses about supporting because of the price. This is why I say Black people spend the most money, but at the same time are the cheapest people on planet Earth. So if I can't urge you to go support Black Mastery, I want you to do this. Remember, I have a video to play on Black Mastery, but I want you to reach out and support the sister Veronica Conway, blackmastery.com. It is very important that you get this life-changing, evolutionary, enhancing tool for your life. I want you to support her, only not for you, not for her, right? But for the sake of the future, because if we continue to give birth to these dead ideas and dead concepts, we're going to always lose. So we have a video that we want to promote. But before I tell you to promote it, remember this. Anybody who signs up for Black Mastery gets a free coaching eval session with her. This is she's one of the best coaches in the world. This is $1,000 get down for the time she's spending with you for free. Black Mastery, check this video out right now.
And one of the greatest tragedies in life is getting to the end of your life and looking back and realizing it was mediocre and it didn't have to be that way. The number one reason is people are unwilling to listen and care about what's important to the other person. What if you could be someone who dared to care about everybody in your life? When you're in love, smoke gets in your eyes. But when you're anxious, you talk more than you listen. I asked my wife a month ago, I said, I don't know whether to have an affair or buy a motorcycle. And she said, if you have an affair, I'll kill you. If you get the motorcycle, you'll kill yourself. Go with the bike.
Oh, God.
We love your intro. It's just the best.
Oh, I love that music. Just straight out of the Catskills, I think they've blown up 20 years ago.
Smooth Corinthian leather.
Dr. G, your tools, please. Tools.
Well, there's a great website, alternet.org. This site gets, this is kind of an alternative Huffington Post. I mean, it just says it the way it is. And a couple days ago, I put up this blog, 12 Hints It's Time to Call It Quits in Your Relationship, and it's one of the most popular blogs there in the last few days. You can see there's 1,100 likes. So let me read these to you. This is kind of like from a kvetchy wife from the Catskills.
Gotcha.
12 Hints It's Time to Call It Quits in Your Relationship. You can't stand the sight of them and they make your skin crawl.
Right.
You're afraid of them.
Yeah.
Friends keep telling you to get out.
Go.
They are mean to the children.
Mm.
The children are afraid of them.
Mm.
You can't remember anything good about them. You no longer enjoy anything with them or look forward to doing anything with them. They come in the door and your heart sinks. You don't want to go out with them, with friends or family, because they're just too embarrassing to you.
Oh, God.
Ugh. They keep making promises they don't keep. You're no longer proud of them. And these little quirks you thought were amusing at the beginning are now embarrassing to you. Here's a bonus hint. They keep violating the restraining order you put on them. So here's the good and bad news. The good news is if this list applies to you, you're not alone. If this applies to your relationship, there are probably people who would want to help you make the break when you decide to do it.
Wow.
The bad news for you, if any of the list applies, it is probably not going to get any better by itself. The bad news for me is my wife came up with a list.
Here we go.
The list could also, this may sound like it's about a woman complaining about a man. I'd say a man could complain about this, except the difference is the first one, because women might think, oh, you can't stand the sight of them and they make your skin crawl. But I think what a man would say is, she makes me feel like running head on and putting my head through the wall. When a woman drives you crazy or you feel like exploding. But Jeff Brown has something. If a woman would give you just nuts in your head, what would it make you feel like doing?
What would it make me feel like doing? I don't know. Wow.
That's hilarious.
Because you actually have described my Jackie. No, not Kim. Kim, we were just too young.
We just a couple of dumbass kids. We didn't have cam girls.
So Jackie had a worse. Jackie had a worse. What would you make you feel like doing in your head? Dude, what would go on in your head?
My prayers changed. Like, I'd be driving down the road going, oh,
my prayers,
dear God, please let a sniper shoot right in the car. I don't care who he hits. Either one. Where's the sniper? Where is the sniper? I want to drive.
You prayed for a sniper?
Oh, my God. I used to drive around the neighborhood till the lights went out, dude. I was not, oh, my God. That bitch is still up. She is still up.
The lights are still on.
Oh, my God.
So take me out of my misery. I don't care if it's me or her. Just take me out of my misery.
You know what? I'm just going to pull a pin on a grenade. I'm just going to pull a pin. I just couldn't take it, man. I could not take it. I think when you get to the point that nothing you do makes a person happy, that actually makes you free. That's what I told you. You freed me. Nothing I do make you happy, so fuck it. I'm going to do what I want to do.
I'm going to do whatever now.
I'm going to do whatever. Draws or walk around my drawers in front of your parents. Whatever.
What made you finally